Now, the Taliban have completely established their rule in Afghanistan. They have announced an interim government comprising of all their leaders. Yet the transformation from an insurgent group to the one in power is never easy. Governing a bitterly divided land ravaged by decades of conflicts is perhaps more difficult than winning a war. And the path ahead is a challenging one. Let's just look at a few challenges here. Factional rifts. Several ideological and factional differences were swept aside during the war on Western occupation. But now with the group coming to power, those differences have resurfaced, especially the turf between Haqqani Network and other factions, which has been attributed to the delay in announcing a government. In terms of the structure of the new government, the leaders of some substantive ministries like the Interior Defense and Foreign Affairs are all members of the Taliban. But the cabinet is only an acting government. As per the spokesperson, Jabiullah Mujahid, the group will try to take people from other parts of the country too, which might include former government officials, secular people and non-Pashtuns. And this amounts to a challenge, to the second challenge here, that is hardline versus moderate. The identity crisis and role transformation. There is a challenge now to find a balance between first, adhering to the Islamic fundamentals and secondly, achieving moderation, inclusiveness and openness. Taliban have emphasized the need for rule under Sharia law. And on the other hand, they've also promised to respect Afghan women's rights to work and study. It is difficult to expect a complete transformation of a conservative movement, especially the one which has fought for the restoration of the old order under the banner of the Islamic Emirate. What remains to be seen is how far will the Taliban leadership go in accepting pluralism and changing their regressive views on women. Many for the international community to recognize the new dispensation. And de-linking terror groups. Now, one of the biggest possible challenges for the Taliban here is to abandon their past adherence to extremism. But the new formed government does not give out an impression of a moderate Taliban. The new Prime Minister, Mullah Hassan Akhund, is a United Nations sanction list, is on the United Nations sanction list. The Interior Minister, Sirajuddin Haqqani, is the leader of the Haqqani Network and again, a UN-designated terrorist. Earlier, the Al-Qaeda was quick to bask in the glory of Taliban's victory on social media. Detailed congratulatory messages and expectations were circulated online. Several reports have even suggested thousands of terrorists are still active on the Afghan soil, including two factions of Al-Qaeda, Haqqani Network and Pakistani Taliban. For now, the image transformation does not look too promising. Then we have the international sanctions. Let's talk about the immediate challenges. International sanctions for now, the Taliban have ignored the sanctions imposed by the international community. But these restrictions will not only apply to the financial transactions, but to business, investment, imports and currency. Companies and banks are bound to comply under the terror financing and money laundering framework. Implications will impair Afghanistan's currency, the $7 billion natural gas pipeline and other infrastructure projects will also suffer. And of course, we know this, the economy is in peril. The world will watch the Taliban and its ability in governing a country facing deep economic crisis and a humanitarian disaster caused by drought and hunger. There have been no discussions or announcements on balancing the priorities of the new government. The deep economic crisis has been made worse by the loss of thousands of trained and educated specialists who have either lost their lives or have fled the country. One of the poorest countries in the world, Afghanistan now faces being cut off from the billions of dollars in foreign aid that kept the economy afloat.
On my orders, the United States military has begun strikes against Al-Qaeda terrorist training camps and military installations of the Taliban regime in Afghanistan.
Over two decades, bin Laden has been Al-Qaeda's leader and symbol, and has continued to plot attacks against our country and our friends and allies. The death of bin Laden marks the most significant achievement to date in our nation's effort to defeat Al-Qaeda.
He United States did what we want to do in Afghanistan, to get the terrorists who attacked us on 9/11 and deliver justice to Osama bin Laden, and to degrade the terrorist threat to keep Afghanistan from becoming a base from which attacks could be continued against the United States. We achieved those objectives. That's why we went.
Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.